Dear students, let us study the fifth program today. The fifth program in the Data Structures and the Applications lab is on design, develop and implementing a program in C by using the stack application. So we have to evaluate a suffix expression with single digit operands and the operators plus, minus, multiplication, division, modulus and to the power of, which are the binary operators. In the previous lab program, we have seen how we can go for converting an infix expression into a postfix expression. So we know that we have three types of expressions: infix expression, prefix expression, and postfix expression. In the infix expression, the operator will always come in between the operands. And in the prefix, the operator always comes before the operands. And in the postfix expression, an operator always comes after the operand. So when we are converting an expression from the infix to the prefix or infix to the postfix, we will take the help of the data structure called as the stack. Only by making use of the stack, we can go for converting from the infix form to the prefix form or from the infix to the postfix. In this particular lab program, we will concentrate on how we can go for evaluating a postfix expression. So we know that we can convert an expression from infix to postfix and then go for evaluation. So here we can see four examples where with parenthesis and without parenthesis, how we are converting an infix expression into a postfix expression. Because for this program, for evaluating a postfix expression, the input should be a postfix expression. When we go for evaluating a postfix expression, the postfix expression will be of the form where it will be consisting of operands and operators. There won't be any parenthesis because when we are converting, already we have removed the parenthesis based on their significance. And now we only have an expression which will be consisting of operators and operands. So if I have an expression like ABC star plus, and I'm going to assign the value A equals 1, B equals 2, and C is equal to 3, the answer will be equal to 7, because first we are going to multiply 2 into 3, which is equal to 6, and then 1 will be added. So totally the answer will be equal to 7. So postfix expression will be a string of characters which will be having operands and operators, and the output, it will be a single integer value. And you can see here the first three expressions, it is consisting of alphabetical values and the operators. But when you go for the programming, you have to give single digit operands. Why? Because we cannot go for ABC slash star. If you go for such type of expression, then you'll have to substitute the values for the ABC and then go for evaluating it. So in this program, we're going to do it directly by giving the single digit operands. So the expression here, 1, 2, 3, star, star, it means that 1 is a number, 2 is the second number, 3 is the third number, and then 2 multiplication symbols. These characters are present in a string. So first we will go for multiplying 2 and 3. So 2 into 3 will be equal to 6, the innermost one. Then, and 6 into 1, it will be equal to 6. That will be the answer what we are going to get. Then we have one more postfix expression, 1, 2, 3, division plus. So here, 2 divided by 3, it will be done first. And then that result, it will be added with 1. So 2 divided by 3, it is equal to 0, plus 1, it will be equal to 1. So we can evaluate either by using alphabetical values or by using numeric values. If you are using alphabetical values, you need to substitute the values for these alphabets and then go for evaluating. And if you are going for numeric values, you should remember that we can do this evaluation only with single digit operands. We can't go for having multiple digit operands like 11, 12 and all. we can't have. We can only have single digit operands from 1 to 9. In this program, the input is a postfix or a suffix expression. This postfix or a suffix expression, it will be consisting of operands and operators. Because the operands and the operators, both of them should be stored in this array, we can have an array of characters. So the input is a string. And then the output, it is a numeric value. The numeric value, it can be integer or it can be floating point value. And to evaluate this expression, we are going to make use of the stack data structure. The stack here, it is going to store the intermediate results and the numbers what are present in the postfix expression. The numbers nothing but the operands. We are going to store the operands in this stack. And the stack is also storing the intermediate results until we get the final answer. The stack, it can be an integer stack or it can be a floating point stack depending upon what type of numeric value we want to extract from the program. So let us see what steps we have to follow for evaluating this postfix expression. First, we have to scan the postfix expression. And every character over here has to be seen whether it is an operand or an operator. Second step is, if the character what I am reading, it is a number, we have to push that onto the stack. The step 3 is, if the element is an operator, then what we have to do, we have to pop the top two operands from the stack. And step 4 is, the operands what we popped from the stack, they have to be evaluated with the operator what has been read. And then this intermediate result, it has to be put back to the stack. Finally, the step 5 is, when the expression is ending, that means when we come across the null character in the input suffix expression, that means all the characters have been read now. So we have to go back to the stack and pop out what is remaining, and that becomes the step 6, and that is the final answer. So we have to have a stack here which is going to store the operands. That means here the stack is going to store the values what has to be read from the suffix expression. So here we will have mainly the work of computation being done in the compute function, and the reading of the input and storing as well as the printing the final result being done in the main function. We will have two functions here. We can do by using one function also, but to distinguish the computation and the actual part of the program. So the actual part of the program is written in the main and the computations are being done in the compute function. So the main program, it will read the input string and it will store the intermediate results on the stack. It will store the values what is being read from the input onto the stack. And it will also pass the top two operands and the operator to the compute function for evaluating. Finally, after getting the answer from the compute function, we can go for printing the final result. And in the compute function, we are going to take the input as two operands and one operator. And then we are going to compute it by using a switch case statement by taking the top two operands and the operator, and the answer is returned to the main function. Let me an example here. I have taken an expression that is the suffix expression 1, 2 plus, 3 plus, 4 plus. So this is a valid suffix expression. I want to evaluate this suffix expression. So we have the characters here 1, 2, plus, 3, plus, 4, plus, and at the last we have the null character. So it will be read in that order. One by one we are going to read the characters, and then based on whether it is an operator or an operand, we are going to take the action. So first, when we read the character 1, So this is a number. This is an operand. So if it is an operand, according to the algorithm, it should go to the stack. So we move the 1 to the stack and then we go for the next character. See here, the input string 1, 2 plus, 3 plus, 4 plus, this is an array of characters. When it is present in the array of characters, each of them will be a character. But when I want to evaluate, I want the numeric value, I don't want the character value. So what I have to do, I have to convert that character value to the numeric value and then I have to go for the evaluation. How this can be done? So we are going to take the reference value as 0. 0 is having the ASCII value as 48. So character 0, it is equal to 48. Character 1, it will be equal to 49. So if I do 49 minus 48, then I'm going to get the value as 1. So this 1 is different from character 1. The character 1, it is having its ASCII value as 49. But this is a numeric 1. So we have to do this for every number whenever we are moving this onto the stack. Then only we are going to get the proper answer, because I don't want the ASCII values. I only want the numeric values. 1 means it should be equal to the numeric 1. I don't want the ASCII value 49. That is why this is one point you have to remember in this program when we are going for moving the number onto the stack from the postfix expression. Now, the second character what is read is 2. 2 is ASCII value. We have to convert that to numeric value. I hope you remember how you can go for converting. So, character 2 minus character 0, when you do, you are going to get the value as the number 2. So that 2, it has to be put onto the stack. So previously we had 1 on the stack. On top of it, now we are going to store the number 2. So the top will be pointing to the topmost number in the stack. In the step 3, we are going to read the character plus. So this plus is an operator. It is not an operand. So when we come across an operator, what we have to do, we have to pop out the top two characters or top two values what is present in the stack. So we had 1 and 2. So they will be popped out and then 1 and 2 will be added because we have the operator plus. And I'm going to get an answer called as 3. And this is my intermediate result because more characters are remaining in the input. So the 3 is pushed back to the stack. Step 4. 3 is read. So 3 is a operand. It is a number. It is a ASCII value. Convert that to numeric value and then you have to put that onto the stack. Previously 3 was stored. Now on top of 3, now this 3, which is the input 3, that will be stored. In the step 5, we come across plus again. So this is an operator. So in the operator, we are coming across the operator. This operator means that I have to do the operation. So I am going to pop out the top two operands from the stack, which was 3 and 3. And I'm going to do the computation and put that back onto the stack. So 6 is stored on the stack here. In the step 6, when we are going to read the 4 value, this value as usual, we have to convert that to the integer form, that means numeric form from the character form, and it has to be moved to the stack. Whenever we have the input as the operator, pop two operands and do the operation. Whenever we have the character as the number, just put that onto the stack. That is the two simple rules for this program. Now we come across the plus. When we come across a plus, because this is an operator, we have to pop out the top two operands. So on the top, we have the 4 and then I have the 6. So pop out these two and then do the computation 4 plus 6 and then put the result back onto the stack. So when we come to the end of the input string, the last character will be the null character. So when we read the null character, it indicates that all the characters in the input are over. So I need to go for the final computation. So what we are going to do, whatever is present on the stack, that is the final answer. So if we pop out whatever is present in the bottom of the stack, that is the answer what we are going to get for this evaluation. So we have seen how the input what we are going to read character by character until we come across a null character, it can be either an operator or an operand. So based on the operator or the operand, we have to put that onto the stack or we have to go for evaluating the top two operands from the stack. So this is the final answer for this expression. One more point which is very important to remember here is, suppose I have the intermediate expression like 6, 4 and divide symbol. That means I want to divide 6 by 4. So when I am putting onto the stack, 6 will be first put onto the bottom and then 4 will be placed on it. So when I am extracting this for the operation, we should always remember that whichever is coming from the top, that will be the operand 2, because 6, 4 slash is same as 6 slash 4. That means I want to divide 6 by 4. So 6 will be the operand 1 and 4 will be the operand 2. But when we are putting onto the stack, because of the stack property, the 6 will be going to the bottom and 4 will be placed on top of it. So when we are popping out, we should always remember whenever we have to go for evaluation, the topmost one will be the operand 2 and the next one will be the operand 1. This is a simple rule we have to remember when we go for the evaluation expression. I hope you understood the logic for evaluating the suffix expression. Here, two points are significant. First one is we have to convert the ASCII value to the number before storing onto the stack. Second one is whenever we are having the suffix expression, the topmost operand, that will be the operand 2. And then we are coming across the operand 1. And in this program, in the expression, there will be two things, operator and the operand. Whenever we have the operand, just put that onto the stack. Whenever you come across an operator, pop out the two most top operands and then go for evaluation. And put that onto the stack again until you come across the null character. Once you come across the null character, whatever is remaining in the stack, that is the final answer. Hope you have understood this program. Thank you.